peace and love, black families, the Prince of Pan-Africanism, Dr. Umar Johnson, we live and direct. I want to give a shout out to Black Ice TV. Make sure you watch it, support it, the news you can use, the information you can use, youth, Pan-Africanism, economics, family, community. Make sure you support Black Ice TV, because Dr. Umar Johnson does.
Sacred is sacred, on the dime, mother and father is the basics. Rise like you're supposed to slip out the matrix. Still dumbstruck, thinking this is entertainment. Escape to reality.
Yeah, I keep it raw like Sarah Seti. Hotep, but if you're an enemy, you catch a broke net. Bang on the system like bullets from barrels released. Zulu comedic like African Bombata. The beast got a hold of the streets, rectify it like Malcolm. Watch your friends and your enemies, never doubt them. Never should you participate in their traditions, cause when you do, you put your own life into submission. Who's the victim? Tell me who the fuck will listen and step up and take charge. Most are caught slipping. If you don't stand for nothing, fam, then you fall for anything.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, family, and welcome to Black Eyes TV 7 Bite Size. Now, the purpose for doing this video, or should I say these bite size videos, are to provide snippets of information to those of us too busy to be able to find the information, or even who are new to the information and want to take it in little chunks, just digestible portions. So, Black Eyes TV 7 Bite Size. Anyway, the topic for today will be Christmas, or more to the point, the truth about Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. And from now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Yeah, me and my friend, I'm a big deal. Wanna listen up, you know I'm very important. Important for real. And me, me tell you straight, I'm a big deal. Christmas, it is a big deal. In a Jamaica, it's very, very, very important. Important for real.
You hear that, boy? That's what Christmas is all about.
Actually, Granddad, Christmas is a pagan holiday. And Jesus probably hates you for celebrating it.
There ain't gonna be no Scrooges in this house, boy.
Look, Granddad, it's clear from the scripture that Jesus was not born in winter. The shepherds who saw the angels announcing his birth would not have been out in their fields in December. The Palestinian winters are too cold, if you believe in that sort of thing. The truth is, Christmas evolved from the Roman holiday Saturnalia, a winter festival where men gave gifts to each other. They also would get drunk, have sex with each other, and beat their wives. People would act so crazy on Christmas, the holiday was outlawed by the Protestant Church until the 1800s.
Many people believe that Christmas is about either giving expensive gifts or believing in the birth of a man called Jesus, or have a fat guy dressed in red break into their house, yam their food, and then take credit for the presents that they spent most of the year saving up for. Now, is this what Christmas is about? Well, no, no, and no.
Christmas was not celebrated in December 25th. For hundreds of years, it was celebrated in August. They moved it to December 25th because that's the Egyptian celebration of the birth of the son of the sun. Talking about Heru and Osiris.
What we find is that in this story that came out of Kemet, after Aset reconstituted the body of her husband Asar, the spirit of Asar came and impregnated his virgin wife, Aset. And then 9 months later, the virgin Aset gave birth to her son, Heru. And Heru was born 4,000 years ago on December 25th.
So in 325, it was decided that Jesus Christ would be a son of God. In 325, it was decided that Jesus Christ would be born in the manger in Bethlehem. Up until the Nicene Council, most people believed that Jesus Christ was born in a cave in Ethiopia, even in Ethiopia till today.
Well, at that time, the biggest ancient festival was something called Saturnalia. This was a festival celebrating the god Saturn that lasted a little over a week starting on December 17th. The ancient Romans chose this time to celebrate Saturn because it was during winter solstice, which is when the sun is in a very specific position in the sky. Now, we won't get too far into that, but listen, once you learn why Saturday is named after Saturn and why Sunday is named after the sun, and notice how most religious activities take place on one of those 2 days, a lot of things will start making sense to you. Anyway, so Constantine thought, since everybody's already celebrating at this time, I can just make this the day that we celebrate Jesus, and the whole world can make a much easier transition to Christianity. You gotta realize that at this time, most people worshipped multiple deities and were so-called pagans. Well, since Constantine and the Council of Nicaea were hell-bent on making Christianity the most powerful religion on earth, they just slapped their holidays on top of pagan holidays so the people could convert easier.
The image that we have of Santa Claus is the rosy-cheeked European jolly guy, and that image was created sometime in the early 1800s. But the real Santa Claus was a man by the name of St. Nicholas. And when I do research about St. Nicholas, the real St. Nicholas, the further back I go, the blacker St. Nicholas gets. And when you look at pictures and portraits of St. Nicholas in museums in Europe, St. Nicholas is totally black. And there's a museum in Italy that has an old painting of St. Nicholas, and he has like dark skin, woolly hair. So people have to realize that the Santa Claus that we know and love today is based on a black saint from Europe.
Did you know that St. Nick was a bishop in the Church of Turkey? He anonymously gave 3 bags of gold to a poor family, and after that, everybody just made up this legend about anonymous gifts coming from a guy named St. Nicholas, and Santa Claus was born. Now he lives in the North Pole, even though he's from the Middle East. So that means that originally, Santa Claus's gift giving was a noble act of helping the poor. But in the 1800s, companies found that it was far more profitable to make it about little kids, because of course people buy gifts for kids before they buy them for poor people, and so companies like Macy's started using Santa's name to make Christmas into a corporate capitalist fiasco.
So at the end of this video, what can we conclude? The fictional story of White Santa is based upon the factual story of Black St. Nicholas, who gave out money to help the poor. Although Africans and Europeans both gave out presents for their celebrations, Africans gave gifts to celebrate their spirituality, while Europeans gave gifts to perpetuate sodomy and debauchery. Not only is the origin story of European Jesus almost an exact replica of the origin story of African Heru, but the birth of Jesus was moved from approximately August to the birthday of Heru, a pagan day, so Christmas has nothing to do with December. And since I mentioned it, who are the pagans? The pagans are people that do not subscribe to the main 3 monotheistic religions, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, and were almost specifically sun worshippers, meaning they were mainly black people. These so-called pagans were brutally murdered by the leaders and believers of religions, out of the kindness and love of their gods. So the truth behind Christmas is this: December the 25th has nothing to do with the Europeans. The winter solstice was a time when black people gathered to celebrate life, health, and give presents in relation to the rebirth of the life-giving sun. It has been replaced with celebrations of gluttony and lust, present giving in the name of financiers, pride and avarice, promoting emotions of envy and wrath. Gluttony, lust, pride, avarice, envy, and wrath. 6 of the 7 deadly sins, the 7th being sloth. The laziness of the people to never even research the hypocrisy of the day they worship on, to spend literally billions of pounds on one day, but can't even afford the effort to help the homeless, casually walking to the garbage bin to throw away excess food, while the starving are sitting in the cold a few meters away outside of Tesco's. For a day that was meant to be good and is now said to be good, it definitely seems to evoke a lot of subtle, ignorant evil. Merry Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. And from now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Yeah, me and my friend, I'm a big deal. Wanna listen up, you know I'm very important. Important for real. And me tell you straight, I'm a big deal. Christmas, it is a big deal. In a Jamaica, it's very, very, very important. Important for real.